Hi there, folks, and thanks for joining us here on the web. The defense in the Seth Mazzaglia murder trial is continuing their efforts to undermine the credibility of the state's star witness, Kat McDonough. McDonough was Mazzaglia's girlfriend and was there the night that Lizzie Marriott was killed. Now, the defense says that McDonough killed Marriott and that she was the one controlling the relationship. Ray Brewer has today's testimony so far.
The defense continued to hammer away at the state's case during a second day of cross-examining the prosecution's star witness, Kat McDonough. The state contends that Seth Mazzaglia controlled McDonough, playing the role of master and she playing the role of slave. McDonough said while in the relationship, she didn't see it that way.
I never said that I was controlled by Seth. I said that he had helped me make a lot of decisions in my life and helped steer me in the direction I went.
McDonough went on to say that once Mazzaglia was arrested and she spent time away from him, her view began to evolve.
I started getting more and more angry at how I had been treated, and so my disposition towards him had slowly started to change.
However, the defense then brought up a recorded conversation that McDonough had with another woman, which would seem to refute the state's contention of Mazzaglia as the one in control.
I started the whole thing. I was the one who started flirting with him. We were doing a show together.
McDonough explained that statement away by saying it was a lie and that at that time she told a lot of lies.
Don't forget, you can also watch the trial right here on our website or stay up to date by checking out our live updates from the newsroom. We'll have a wrap-up of today's testimony starting tonight at 5 o'clock. And a Nashua man is behind bars this afternoon, accused of assaulting and holding a woman against her will for several hours. Officials say yesterday afternoon they received a call from a female victim saying she was being held in her apartment. Jonathan Gerald reportedly held the woman captive for 5 hours. Pushing her around, choking her, threatening to stab her with a knife and pour hot oil on her. Police say the victim had a few cuts and bruises, but no life-threatening injuries. Gerald is now being held without bail. In an early morning assault investigation taking place in Goffstown, police were called to an area of Mast Road before 6 this morning after receiving a call that a woman was being assaulted there. The suspects left the scene apparently at a high rate of speed. Witnesses were able to give police a description of the suspect's car, which a short time later was involved in a crash on Yeovil Street in Manchester. Police are still investigating and no arrests have been made, but they do say this doesn't appear to be a random act. And police are also looking for the man they say robbed a gas station on Main Street in Exeter. Authorities say the man was armed with a small kitchen knife and used his T-shirt to cover his face. Fortunately, no one was hurt during this encounter. Now to an unusual sight, though, on Hampton Beach. Two young deer spent the morning in the waves as police, surfers, and beachgoers looked on. Fish and game officials were called to the scene, and they eventually had to rescue the two from the crashing waves. As you can imagine, this was no easy task. Both of the deer are okay, but tonight we're going to hear from those who witnessed and took part in the rescue. And starting tonight at 5 o'clock as well, we're going to have much more on the ceremonies marking the anniversary of D-Day, including the stories of three New Hampshire women serving in the military that day. And a warning for parents as we head into summer, why more children are drowning after being pulled out of the water and what you can do to protect them. For now, that's going to do it for us. Until then, have a great afternoon.